Assalamu alaikum. For those of you who have just joined, my name is Maryam Musa, and I'll be taking you through the English modules for this workshop. As for my introduction, I have been associated with the Student Factory for the past 3 years, and we've done multiple trainings at LAMS for different things, for different types of students and different levels. Meri apni education jahan tak sawal hai, I have done my undergrad in economics and social sciences, and then I did my master's in international comparative education / policy analysis from Stanford. And now I am working at the Citizens Foundation, and I am doing part-time trainings with DCF. Moving on to today's content, this lesson may be going to cover sentence construction, which is one part of the verbal portion of GMAT. And we're going to discuss common errors and some topics that are tested very frequently. So one of the things, and for that, basically we need to brush up on our grammar and go over some basic rules which can't ensure that you'll get the answer right, because for English, you don't have any tricks that can ensure that if you do this, you'll get the right answer. However, we will try to discuss some tips and try to have more educated guesses if we reinforce all of these rules and tips. The first thing that we'll talk about is basically misplaced modifiers. Does anyone know what modifiers are? Modifiers, basically, as the name suggests, are a set of words or a clause that is modifying some part of the sentence. And they're misplaced when they're far away from what they're modifying. For example, in this particular sentence, if you see the sentence that says disgusting and pus-filled, Enrico nursed his festering wound. Does it sound right? Disgusting and pus-filled, Enrico nursed his festering wound. Those of you who think it sounds right, please raise your hand. Disgusting and pus-filled, Enrico nursed his festering wound. I see a few hands. Those of you who think it's incorrect, please raise your hand. I see more hands. And most of the hands didn't really show, so I'm assuming most of you don't have an answer to that. This is incorrect, and that's because modifier here is away from what it's explaining. The right answer to this would be if you place the modifier right next to what it's explaining, which is the wound. So disgusting and pus-filled is not for Enrico. It's, what is it for? It's for the? Yeah, it's for the wound, exactly. So if those two adjectives are for the wound, then they need to be closer to that noun. In the correct sentence, the one showing at the end of the screen, it says Enrico nursed his disgusting and pus-filled festering wound. So now the modifier is with that noun, and this is the correct form of it. How can you tell if the modifier is misplaced? There are a few signals to tell if the modifier is misplaced, and that is that an introductory phrase is a common signal of a misplaced modifier. So just like in this sentence, disgusting and pus-filled was the modifier. It was placed right at the start of the sentence. However, its actual place was with the noun that it was modifying, and that was the wound, which means it was misplaced. Any modifying phrase which is not close to what it modifies may also indicate this error. That's what we have just talked about. Another example. Career switchers often schedule interviews with high-level managers, believing that the insight of professionals will help narrow down the many choices of careers available to graduating MBAs. Does anyone have an idea of what the correction would be? You can take 30 seconds to process it. Career switchers often schedule interviews with high-level managers, believing that the insight of professionals will help narrow down the many choices of careers available to graduating MBAs. Remember, the tip to do this is to first identify what the modifier is. And if anyone has an answer, please raise your hand. Any guesses would do, it's fine. Even if any of the guesses is incorrect, it's okay. How about I give you options? So these are our options. and pick one now. Should be easier now. Remember, the first one will always be the one that is in the sentence. And as we discussed it in the first lecture as well, that we don't need to read the first option because it's the one that's already present in the stem. Sorry. Yes? Sorry, E. So there's one person who says E. B for bat. So we have E for elephant and B for bat. Anyone else? Sorry? E. E for elephant. Any other guesses? Do you want to see what the right answer is? So the answer to this is B. Yep. Who said B? Yeah. Why is it B though? G? Exactly. So what was the modifier here? Believing that the insight of professionals will help narrow down the many choices of careers available to graduating MBAs. This was the modifier. Asal baat kya thi? Career switchers often schedule interviews with high-level managers. This was the actual. So remember, I told you have to identify subject, verb, direct object, indirect object. What's the subject here? Career switchers, exactly. So career switchers are the subject. What are they doing? They're scheduling interviews. So what's the verb? Object, yeah, with high level managers. The modifier is a beach ki baat hai, that is the modifier, and it belongs right next to career switches. Any questions? Okay. The next thing we'll discuss is agreement. Subject verb bhi hoti hai, multiple types hoti hai. And this is a very common problem that is tested in sentence correction, and it's usually between the verb and the subject. If it's a number, for example, then the plural verb, if it's greater than one, then you need to use plural verbs. If it's a singular noun, then you have to use a singular verb. Sometimes collective nouns can confuse people. So a flock of birds or a group of students. Now you can argue that they're in number, they're more than one, but since they basically are a bunch, and they are, when using a collective noun, what do you think we'll use? Will we use a plural verb or will we use a singular verb? Exactly, we'll use a singular verb. So jab bhi we're using collective nouns, we'll use singular verbs. For example, in this case, a flock of birds flying south for the winter was above us. It's not were, it's was. Subject kya hai there? Flock of birds. And that is a collective noun, which is why we're using singular verb. Yep. Similarly, a group of fourth graders are so well behaved. Is this correct? My group of fourth graders are so well behaved. Those of you who think it's correct, do this. Those of you who think it's incorrect, do this. Those of you who think it's correct, do this. Those of you who think it's incorrect, do this. So that I can see. Cool, I see a lot of thumbs down. Why is it incorrect? Front row, any guesses? Dekhiye subject kya hai idhar? Group of fourth graders jo hai wo hamara subject hai. Is that singular or plural? That is one collective noun. Group jo hai, that is a collective noun, and whenever we're talking about collective nouns, we'll use singular verbs, which is why R is incorrect. And R ke jagah kya aayega? Yep. So we write, my group of fourth graders is so well behaved. Some signals that can tell you that this problem exists are that collective nouns such as team, audience, staff, family, public, or committee are singular. An intervening phase which separates the noun from the verb is used to confuse some test takers. Other than that, a sentence structure with the verb before the subject may indicate an agreement error. So, for example, if the verb is before the subject, tab bhi sign hai ki shayad sentence mein koi gadbad hai. So, always identify subject, verb, object. Then it's always easier to spot the error. Tenses. So, tenses can't be improved overnight or even in a week. But when you keep practicing and when you read more and solve more questions that have issues with tenses, that will give you more confidence to deal with these questions. And tenses are very frequently tested on all standardized tests. So that is something that you need to improve if you feel like that's a weakness. For example, in this particular statement, as soon as I hear the dog bark, I knew you were at the door. What's the problem with this sentence? As soon as I hear the dog bark, I knew you were at the door. Tense alignment is the problem. Tenses align nahi hai ek hi sentence ke andar. As soon as I hear the dog bark, I knew you were at the door. Here is present and knew is past. Exactly. So as soon as I heard the dog bark, I knew you were at the door. Exactly. We've discussed this, that in this example, the future tense makes clear the dog's barking is anticipated by the speaker. Sorry? That's okay too. Yeah, you can, it has to be tense alignment. Yeah. Okay, so this is going to be a useful table for people who struggle with tenses. And you might want to note it down if you think this is one of your weak areas. What we're going to do is that sentences can have multiple clauses. So sometimes there's a main clause and sometimes there's an independent clause. And we need to see in which cases is it okay to mix tenses. For example, if the main clause isn't present, but the independent clause is simple present, it shows the same time action. For example, I'm eager to go for a walk because I enjoy exercise. So I'm eager to go for a walk is present because I enjoy exercise is simple present. That is something that, that although they're not exactly the same tenses, it's still okay because this is showing a same time action. If you have to show earlier action, then the main clause will be present and the independent clause will be simple past. Agar aapne show karna hai ki action pehle ho chuka hai, to indicate an earlier action. He feels that she made a mistake last year. Ab he feels is present. But she made a mistake last year is simple past. So what is this showing? It is showing that we are referring to an earlier action. Refer abhi kar rahe hain, present mein kar rahe hain. Lekin kar kis cheez ko rahe hain? Past mein. So here it's okay to have the main clause in present and to have the independent clause in simple past. Moreover, if we want to show that the period of time is extending from some point in the past to present, extend ho raha hai. It hasn't ended and it hasn't started just now. It started from the past and it's coming now to the present. Then we can use the main clause in present and the other clause can be present perfect. The congregation believes that it has selected a suitable preacher. It started in the past, but it's now being continued to the present. So the congregation believes that it has selected a suitable preacher. Next is when you want to show any action to come, then you can start your main clause in present and the other clause can be in future. My teacher says that he will grade the tests next week. Moving on to simple past tense, if you want to show that the action was completed in the past, then you have to make sure that both of the clauses have past tense. Both of them need to be in simple past to show that this particular action has been completed. Then there is no other tense that can be involved here. For example, she cooked the salmon because she knew it was fresh. Cooked bhi simple past hai, she knew it was fresh bhi past hai. So this is showing that the action has been completed in the past. If you want to show an earlier action, you use simple past and past perfect. He cooked the salmon well because he had attended culinary school. Then we talk about if you want to state a general truth. The thing about that is that the absolute facts, the general truth, it doesn't change. It has no present, no past. In that particular situation, we can start with simple past, and the clause, other clause can be in simple present. For example, if we say, as Muslims, we believe God is one, or we all believe that the earth is round, that is an absolute truth. So, we can say that Copernicus believed that the universe is like a giant clock. Then, if you want to show an earlier action, we can start with present perfect, and the other clause can be in simple past. The lawyer has handled many cases since he passed the bar. Earlier action tha, pass kiya bar, and tab se leke ab tak he has handled many cases. To show action happening at the same time, you can use present perfect in both clauses. She has grown a foot because she has taken steroids. I understand that some people will struggle with tenses. And if you feel like this is getting complicated for you, I will refer some additional resources for tenses that can help you assess yourself on where you stand. Because if you don't feel comfortable with these tenses, then it's an indication that you need to read up more on these tenses. Okay, so where were we? We were talking about past perfect. So past perfect, you can use for any purpose at all. And if you combine it with simple past. So past perfect mein agar shuru ho raha hai aur simple past hai, toh phir wo kisi bhi purpose ke liye istemal ho sakta hai. Like the bird had flown for miles before it landed. Then we talk about agar hum future shuru kar rahe hain, and then simple past wala agla clause hai, toh wo tab hoga when you're showing an earlier action. Agar aap start future se kar rahe hain aur agla clause present perfect hai, then you're basically showing future action earlier than the action of the independent clause. This is interesting. So my grandmother will finish the puzzle soon if her dog has not eaten the pieces. My grandmother will finish the puzzle soon is future. If her dog has not eaten the pieces is present perfect. So ye condition lag gayi. To jahan ye ho raha hai ki agar aapne indication karni hai ki wo cheez usse pehle hogi to wo hoga, then it starts with future and the next will be present perfect. For future perfect, agar hum future perfect shuru kar rahe hain and we want simple and we ending it with simple present or present perfect, that can also be used for any purpose. For example, the factory will have produced many widgets long before it closes. The factory will have produced many widgets long before it has closed. So, dono yahan pe ho sakte hai, simple present bhi or present perfect bhi. One word of caution is that do not confuse between the present perfect and the past perfect. Present perfect is has walked and past perfect is had walked. Aur ye dono tenses different time periods ko express kar rahe hain. Has walked is present, had walked is past. Faulty parallelism. So, this is something that you can easily spot and fix if you're aware and if you're conscious of the fact that parallel issues hote hain. They are very mechanical, and all you need to see is अगेन व्हाट इज द सब्जेक्ट, व्हाट इज द वर्ब, व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्ट, एंड देन सी के जिन चीज़ों की बात हो रही है, जो सब्जेक्ट है उनमें अलाइनमेंट कितनी है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, विच डू यू लाइक बेस्ट, टू स्विम, अ ड्राइव और जॉगिंग. दिस इज एक्सट्रीमली मिसअलाइंड. टू स्विम, अ ड्राइव और जॉगिंग, वॉट वुड बी द करेक्शन, वॉट वुड बी द करेक्ट वे टू राइट दिस. Anyone who wants to answer, raise your hand, please. Ji. Sorry? That is partially correct, but partially incorrect. Because alignment tab hogi, jab ye sare verbs parallel honge. Right now, jogging is, what is it? It's present continuous. Yes. Jogging is present continuous, whereas the rest of them aren't. So, the right way to write it, इनमें से कोई भी जो है जो नीचे तीन लिखे हुए हैं, एनी ऑफ देम वुड बी फाइन. विच डू यू लाइक बेस्ट, टू स्विम, टू ड्राइव और टू जॉग. अलाइनमेंट है ना, पैरेलल हो गए. विच डू यू लाइक बेस्ट, अ स्विम, अ ड्राइव और अ जॉग, यहाँ पर भी अलाइनमेंट है. विच डू यू लाइक बेस्ट, स्विमिंग, ड्राइविंग और जॉगिंग, अगेन द अलाइनमेंट इज देयर. हाउ कैन यू स्पॉट के यहाँ पे शायद ये मसला है. अगर इफ यू हैव अ लिस्ट ऑफ आइटम्स, If they've given you a list, then that list needs to be aligned. If that list isn't aligned, then there's a problem. Usually in long phrases and clauses that are connected by conjunctions, it's easy to fool someone, and the error gets easier to ignore because conjunction beech mein aa jati hai, and then you forget that wo tense aur tha, wo tense aur tha, unless you have a lot of practice of identifying these errors. Yes? I'm okay with that too. If you can raise your hands and we can just do a vote. Those of you who want the medium of instruction to be in Urdu, please raise your hand. So apparently there's just two people. those of you who want, I'm comfortable with both of them. So I just want to know whatever is more comfortable for you people. अगर आप लोग उर्दू में लेक्चर कराना चाहते हैं, दैट्स फाइन विद मी. अगर इंग्लिश में करना है तब भी. पीपल हु वांट इट टू बी इन इंग्लिश, पीपल हु आर इंडिफरेंट, ओके. सो मोस्ट ऑफ देम, व्हाट आई विल डू इज मैं बायलिंगुअल कर लेती हूँ, ताकि हम इंग्लिश उर्दू दोनों में वी विल यूज बोथ ऑफ द लैंग्वेजेस. अच्छा, कंपेरिजन्स. Comparisons, so this is a funny line. Comparisons are a first cousin of parallelisms. That is true. So comparisons jab bhi ho rahe hain, ek saying hai, don't compare apples with oranges. Wohi baat hai ki agar aap comparison kar rahe hain, to make sure ki comparison bhi aligned hai, parallel hai. And how do you see that? For example, if I say, I like Amna's cake more than Sana. What am I comparing? I'm comparing a cake with Sana. Does that make sense? No, it doesn't, obviously. So when we're comparing objects, it has to be a comparison between objects. Agar hum subjects compare kar rahe hain, to humne wo alignment wahan honi chahiye. Examples dekhte hain. The judge of the baking contest liked Sally's pastry better than Bob's. Kya masla hai idhar? Bob's pastry, yes, because compare क्या कर रहे हैं हम, pastry को. यहाँ पे क्या compare हो रहा है, pastry और Bob, which doesn't make sense. जी, I can't really hear you. Can you be louder? Thank you. No, it doesn't. So when you हाँ, अच्छा, यू आर सेइंग कि नीचे वाला, या बॉब इज इनकरेक्ट. सो दिस, आई विल टर्न माय नोटिफिकेशंस ऑफ. एनीवे, सो बॉब इज इनकरेक्ट, बट बॉब्स इज फाइन. सो यू कांट कंपेयर बॉब एंड पेस्ट्री, बट बॉब्स इज फाइन बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट इट मींस. इट मींस दैट यू आर कंपेयरिंग बॉब्स पेस्ट्री विद सैलीज पेस्ट्री. यस. how to detect ke is tarah ka koi masla hai. Keywords kis tarah ke honge, like, unlike, compared to, more than, less than. Jab ye ho raha hoga, tab be very alert ke iska matlab hai ki comparison ho raha hai. Aur agar comparison ho raha hai, to phir comparison similar cheezon ka hona chahiye. This is fairly simple. Pronoun, agreement and reference. So, jab hum ladki ki baat kar rahe hain, to hum she or her use karenge. Ladke ki baat kar rahe hain, to hum he or his use karenge. Usually, a common error that GMAT shows is that even for living things, we use its and that's, which is incorrect. People ke liye humne who use karna hai, that use nahi karna kabhi bhi. Humne people ke liye its kabhi use nahi karna. So, whenever we're talking about some nouns, we need to make sure that their pronouns are aligned. Examples, dekh lete hain. In recent years, Fred has tried to lose its excess weight through numerous diets. Correct kya hai? In recent years, Fred has tried to lose his excess weight through numerous diets. Yahan pe masla kya tha ki wahan its tha aur yahan par his hai. I'm not sure. I don't think so. Because phir I think they'll have a technical difficulty with that. Okay, what is the problem with references? Pronoun reference errors occur when ambiguity exists as to the... Achha, so, in simple terms, agar pronoun hai aur sentence mein aur aapko confirm nahi ho raha that what noun is this pronoun referring to, then that's a problem. So in whatever sentence you choose, it has to be very clear what the pronoun is referring to. If there are multiple nouns in the sentence, ye masla usually tab aata hai. For example, the attorney argued that students who were denied the use of school facilities for political activities had lost their right of free assembly. Ab nouns kaun se hain? Attorney, students, school facilities, teen hai. Their kiske liye use ho raha hai? Clear nahi bataya hua. Hum guess kar sakte hain ya we can just guess ki maybe it's for the attorney, maybe for students, but grammatically it's incorrect because it's not very clear ki kis noun ke liye ye pronoun use ho raha hai. The right way of doing it would be the just a second. The clicker isn't working. The attorney argued that students lost their right of free assembly when they were denied the use of school facilities for political activities. Ab it's clear that the attorney argued that students lost their right. Who lost their right? So ab wo confusion clear ho gayi hai, so it's correct. GMAT and GRE, dono mein idioms bahut saare test hote hain. And idioms ke liye there's no set rule or mathematical formula that can tell you ke ye idioms aise sahi honge. What you can do is just, and the only way to see is to read more, and then you will know if that idiom fits well. Hum kuch examples karenge, and you will probably get an idea of what I'm saying. An example is, when compared to Greg's ability to carry a tune, Marsha's music skill is unimpressive. Can you spot any error in this? That's the correct one. When compared with Greg's ability to carry a tune. So compare jab bhi karna hai, to uske liye humne kya word use karna hai? With. It's a common error to use to with compare, but grammatically correct kya hai? Compare with. Comparison kisi cheez ke saath kar rahe hai na? So compare with. Don't compare apple with oranges. When you're illustrating similarities, Then you can use compared to. For example, he compared his teacher to Bruce Greenland, the esteemed professor famous for his value investing lectures at Columbia Business School. So compared to कहाँ पे use करने हैं जहाँ पे हम similarities illustrate कर रहे हैं. But जहाँ सिर्फ comparison हो रहा है वहाँ हम with कर देंगे. अगर similarities कोई हम share कर रहे हैं if you're talking about them then we'll use that. अच्छा, the two of them hated each other with a passion. कहाँ पे each other use करना है और कहाँ पे one another use करना है? Does anyone know? Where to use each other and where to use one another? लिखा है? जी. So if we have two people or two things, then we can use each other. But if we have more than two, then we'll use one another. Just example, mein, the two of them hated each other with a passion. Do the. Ab jab four ho gaye, the four of us looked at one another and laughed. Ek list of idioms. If you want to note it down, you can. This can be helpful. Errors ye hain ki a lot ko sometimes people write it together. They think a lot is a word, but it's not. It's a and it's lot, separate. Agree on must be followed by the ing form of a verb. For example, we say we need to agree on choosing a medium of instruction and we decided to keep it bilingual. So agree on ke baad hamesha ing wala verb aayega. As versus then. Sometimes people confuse as and then and they think they are interchangeable, but they're not. We use as for comparisons of similarity or equality. Jaise as white as snow, toh wo similarity hai. And we use then with the comparative ER. For example, today it's hotter than it was yesterday. Toh yahan pe hum then use kar rahe hain. Jab humne koi comparison karna hai kisi adjective ke saath. और as तब है जब हमने सिमिलैरिटी बतानी है. As good as use नहीं करना, उसकी जगह better than use करना है. As good as is not grammatically very appropriate, but better than is the better choice. Then we use to express similarity. We can say he's as tall as his sister to show that they're similar. Then based on. So based on ka use bhi zara tricky hota hai. The phrasal verb based on is grammatical and can be used either actively or passively. So you can use it either way. You can say the style of her cooking is based on southern cuisine, or you can say she bases her thinking on sound logic. तो ये दोनों फॉर्म में बेस यूज़ हो सकता है. यहाँ पे यू कैन यूज़ इट एक्टिव वॉइस में भी और पैसिव वॉइस में भी. डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर. द कंस्ट्रक्शन इज जनरली एक्सेप्टेड एंड इज सर्टनली प्रेफरेबल टू डिपेंड्स ऑन इफ. सो डिपेंड्स ऑन इफ भी ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट है. दो चीज़ें, डिपेंड्स ऑन इफ और डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर. प्रेफर टू यूज डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर. ज़्यादा सूरतों में डिपेंड्स ऑन वेदर विल बी अप्रोप्रिएट. Okay, depends on whether it rains tomorrow or not. Different from versus different than. Aapke khayal mein what's more appropriate? Different from or different than? लिखा है. या सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक? फ्रॉम डिफरेंट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट देन भी गलत नहीं है, बट ज्यादा अप्रोप्रिएट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम है. जहां डिफर आएगा वहां फॉर श्योर फ्रॉम आएगा. डिफर फ्रॉम, डिफर देन कभी हो ही नहीं सकता. डिफर फ्रॉम होगा, डिफरेंट देन हो सकता है, लेकिन उससे ज्यादा अप्रोप्रिएट है टू से different from, identical with or identical to, dono are appropriate. We can say my bottle is identical to his, or we can say my laptop is identical to her laptop. It's fine. To BHO with BHO, it doesn't matter. Whenever you start a sentence with not only, make sure that there is some but also as well in the sentence. Not only may sentence shuru kiya hai aur but also nahi hai, to phir that sentence is incorrect. Because not only ka matlab bhi, jis tarah agar aapne either likha hai, to phir or likhna bhi zaruri hai. Usi tarah agar aapne not only se shuru kiya hai, to but also bhi zaruri hai. Regardless, regard as, fairly simple. In the interest of time, I will move on to, I will just quickly go over some frequently misused words, because if you don't have a lot of time, hum zyada detail mein in words ke baare mein baat nahi karenge, but I can give you this list at the end if you want to use it for your, in your free time and learn ke kaun se frequently misused words hain. List ka naam bata de, like I'll just say the words out loud. Aggravate and annoy, they are not synonyms. You cannot aggravate human beings. Ago and since, among, between, amount and number, fewer and less. By the way, fewer and less is a very common error. Few or less mein difference ye hai, few aap tab use karenge jab आप countable nouns की बात कर रहे होंगे. So whenever you're talking about something that cannot be counted, that will be less. But when you can count, it will be fewer. Any examples in your mind? Any examples? Yeah. So there were few students in the class, because you can count students. तो वहाँ पे हम few use करेंगे. And if someone's saying, I am feeling a little excited. You can't measure excitement, right? You can't count it. So that will be little, that will not be few. You can't say, I feel a few excited. Good or well ka bhi similar, log confusion kar dete hain. Ke well or good mein difference kya hai? Ke when used as adjectives, good refers to morality or quality and well refers to health. Agar adjective ke sense mein baat ho rahi hai na, to well health ke liye hai aur good jo hai wo quality ke liye hai. You can't say that, agar aap sabhi pooch raha hai ke, how are you feeling? It's better to say, I feel well, as opposed to saying, I feel good. I am well, I'm doing well. If it's not about your health, then you can say, I feel good about my work. Imply, infer, maybe masla aata hai, like, as. So less than, under, more than, over. As we discussed in the previous lesson as well, try to stay away from passive voice. GMAT is usually testing you in a biased way that it prefers active voice. More examples of what we have discussed already. So, we've discussed modifiers. Yahan pe agar hai, having read the book, there is no question the book is better than the film. Correct kya hoga? Having read the book, I have no doubt that the book is better than the film. Now it's clearer, because kisko doubt hai? Mujhe missing modifier tha. Kahin misplaced ho sakta hai, kahin missing bhi ho sakta hai. Whether baked or mashed, Tom loves potatoes. Kya galti hai idhar? A baked or mashed is the modifier. Kiske liye hai wo modifier? पोटेटोज के लिए, टॉम के लिए तो नहीं है ना, सो वाई इज इट नेक्स्ट टू टॉम? इट शुडंट बी. द करेक्ट इज टॉम लव्स पोटेटोज वेदर बेक्ड और मैश. डज इट मेक सेंस? पीपल हु जॉग फ्रीक्वेंटली डेवेलप नी प्रॉब्लम्स. People develop knee problems if they jog frequently. I think we've covered enough for the modifiers. This is important though, that you need to see the proximity between the modifier and the modified object. सो जहाँ पे जस्ट ओनली हार्डली ऑलमोस्ट है वो इट नीड्स टू बी यूज इमीजिएटली बिफोर वट दे मॉडिफाई. अगर बाद में होगा तो मतलब चेंज हो जाएगा. इट हैज़ टू बी बिफोर वट इट्स मॉडिफाइंग. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस द प्रीस्ट ओनली सीज चिल्ड्रेन ऑन ट्यूजडेज बिफोर 4 PM एंड 6 PM. यहाँ पर द प्रीस्ट सीज चिल्ड्रेन only on Tuesdays between 4 PM and 6 PM, or the priest sees children on Tuesdays only between 4 PM and 6 PM. basically matlab change ho raha hai. Do you see that matlab farak hai upar aur niche mein? So agar aap wo uski uska spot change kar denge to matlab change ho jayega. So apne passage mein se dekh ke agar passage given hai ya koi context given hai, you have to decide ki kahan pe matlab appropriate ban raha hai according to the flow. That or which usually interchangeable होते हैं. Little or few का हमने discussion अभी किया कि few students and little excited, जो countable है that is few, that, but जो भी countable नहीं है that is little. Agreement, then again if we use the pronoun they, तो उसके बाद देम सेल्फ आएगा. दे के बाद हिम सेल्फ या हर सेल्फ नहीं आएगा, दैट विल बी इनकरेक्ट. ये भी एक कॉमन एरर है, दैट बुक सीम्स इंटरेस्टिंग सही है, दोज बुक्स सीम इंटरेस्टिंग. डिफरेंस क्या है कि जब प्लूरल है बुक्स तो वो वर्ब सिंगुलर हो जाएगा, दोज बुक्स seem interesting, but जहाँ पे book singular है that book, वहाँ पे जो verb है that has an s, that book seems interesting. Compound subject, for example if you have multiple subjects जैसे रोमियो एंड जूलियट, इन्होंने एग्जाम्पल भी दी हुई है, तो हम इसको रेफर एज अ सिंगल नाउन ही करेंगे. जैसे कलेक्टिव नाउन्स को हमने एज वन किया था रेफर, तो यहाँ पे भी हम रोमियो एंड जूलियट इज अ सिंगुलर नाउन व्हेन इट इज रेफर टू एज अ प्ले, क्योंकि वो कंपाउंड सब्जेक्ट है. अगर हम बात कर रहे होते रोमियो एंड जूलियट एज टू डिफरेंट पीपल तो फिर कहते रोमियो एंड जूलियट आर टू कैरेक्टर्स, बट यहाँ पे हम कंपाउंड सब्जेक्ट की बात कर रहे हैं कि हम इनको ग्रुप कर दिया साथ, तो रोमियो जूलियट जो है वो एक कंपाउंड सब्जेक्ट बन के एक प्ले बना है. सो मीन्स रोमियो जूलियट इज अ गुड प्ले. ईच एंड एवरी वन इनडेफिनिट प्रोनाउंस जो भी होंगे उन सब के साथ भी इज लगेगा, सीम्स लगेगा, मतलब सिंगुलर वाले वर्ब्स लगेंगे. सो ईच एंड एवरी वन की जहाँ बात हो रही है वो सिंगुलर की तरह ट्रीट होंगे. अगर आइदर और भी है या एवरी वन है, जो भी ऐसे प्रोनाउंस होंगे उन सब के साथ इज आएगा, आर नहीं आएगा. हम इनडेफिनिट प्रोनाउंस की एक लिस्ट देख लेते हैं. ईच, ईदर, एनीथिंग, एवरीथिंग, नथिंग, एनीवन, एवरीवन, नो वन, नाइदर, एनीबडी, एवरीबडी, नोबडी, ये सारे इनडेफिनिट प्रोनाउंस हैं. हम इनके लिए सिंगुलर वर्ब्स ही यूज़ करेंगे. वेदर एंड इफ, डू यू हैव एनी आइडिया ऑफ कहाँ वेदर यूज करना है एंड कहाँ इफ?
If is used when we have to say either yes or no.
इफ यूजली कंडीशन के लिए होता है.
इट्स अ
सो
कंडीशन
एग्जैक्टली
एक्चुअली वी डू दैट सो
बिल्कुल. सो जहाँ पे आपके दो ऑप्शंस हैं वेदर दिस और दैट, वहाँ पे आप वेदर यूज़ करें. इफ तब सिर्फ अगर कोई एक कंडीशन आपने यूज़ करनी है तब इफ यूज़ करें, बिकॉज अदरवाइज इफ कैन बी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. सो अगर आपके पास दो चीज़ों में से चॉइस है तो फिर आप वेदर ही यूज़ करें. आई डोंट नो इफ आई एम रेडी टू टेक द टेस्ट नाउ एंड इफ आई विल एवर बी रेडी इन द फ्यूचर इज इनकरेक्ट ग्रामर. करेक्ट ग्रामर क्या है? आई डोंट नो वेदर आई एम रेडी टू टेक द टेस्ट नाउ एंड वेदर आई विल एवर बी रेडी इन द फ्यूचर. दैट इज करेक्ट ग्रामर. अवॉइड रन ऑन सेंटेंसेस, वी डिस्कस दिस पहले भी. अगर आपको दो ऑप्शन ठीक लग रही हैं एंड वन ऑफ देम इज लॉन्गर देन द अदर, देन चूज द शॉर्टर वन. यस, चूज द वन दैट इज मोर कंसाइज एंड मोर प्रिसाइज, क्योंकि रन ऑन सेंटेंसेज आर यूजली ग्रामेटिकली इनकरेक्ट. स्टे अवे फ्रॉम देम. ओके, लेट्स लुक एट दिस एग्जाम्पल. आई विल हाइड द आंसर एंड यू ट्राई टू फिगर आउट क्या आंसर है. क्वेश्चन इज, अनलाइक ली एंग हुज फिल्म्स ट्रांसेंड आइडियोलॉजी, दिस पर्सन इज फ्रीक्वेंटली डिसमिस्ड विद बीइंग मेयरली अ फोटोग्राफर फॉर विजुअली इम्प्रेसिव प्रोडक्शन विद लिटिल मीनिंग. जो जो अंडरलाइंड है उसको चेंज करें. रिमेंबर, फर्स्ट वाला हमेशा वही है जो स्टेम के अंदर है, सो इग्नोर दैट. What's the right answer? जी, what's the right answer? Any guesses? Unanimously, see? What does it say? It's D. Why is it D? बात देखिए आपकी वही थी. आई अंडरस्टैंड दैट यू गॉट टू द पॉइंट वेर यू थॉट एज आना था, बट कंसाइज ज्यादा क्या है. टॉपिक वर्ड इज सी है. सो या फॉर बींग मेरिडली अ फोटोग्राफर इज मोर वर्ड्स. सेकेंडली मेरिडली की प्लेसमेंट भी यहाँ पे गलत है, बिकॉज द एडवर्ब इज प्लेस्ड वेरी फार फ्रॉम द वर्ब. वर्ब और एडवर्ब नीड टू बी टुगेदर. सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल, वंस ऑलमोस्ट कवर्ड अंडर सेंचुरीज of debris, skilled artisans have now restored some original famous paintings during the Italian Renaissance. What do you think is the right answer? Any guesses? Pichla unanimously galat tha. ई, किसी ने ई बोला था अभी. सम ओरिजिनल फेमस पेंटिंग्स ड्यूरिंग द इटालियन रेनेसां हैव नाउ बीन रिस्टोर्ड बाय स्किल्ड आर्टिसन. सो यू नो व्हेन एवरी सिंगल टाइम यू फिगर आउट दिस इज द राइट ऑप्शन, इट विल साउंड रियली सिंपल. जितनी ऑप्शन ज्यादा कॉम्प्लेक्स और कॉम्प्लिकेटेड साउंड करेगी वो उतनी गलत होगी. Now we'll do an activity. I am going to put up some questions on the PowerPoint. If you can dim the lights a little bit, if it's possible. Can you read the text? I can read out loud to you. We've done this. Can you read this? Okay, so I'm going to time you. And you will have 1.5 minutes to do this. You will have 2 minutes to do this. And everyone has to write the answer in their booklets. Your time starts now. When he phones her, she tells him to stop calling. But he acted as if he had not understood her. Let's look at the correct answer. What do you think is the right answer? Oh, so there's... am I hearing B and D? E for elephant, D for dog, B for bat, sai alphabets pure kar lete hain. Someone said B, someone said D, someone said E. Iske alawa kisi ne koi option kiya hai select? C. Did you put it back in the sentence? Remember, ek tip batai thi maine. Jo bhi answer select karein, put it back in the sentence. And then think if it sounds right. How many of you think it's C? Raise your hand. How many of you think it's D? Raise your hand. It is D. Can you read this example? No? Achha, I'll pull up the example on a bigger format. Okay. Is this visible? We have 10 minutes remaining. We started a little bit late, so we can extend it to 15 minutes. 15 minutes mein aapne 10 questions karne hain. Har question mein 1.5 minute ke baad aage kar dungi. At the end, we'll go over answers and explanations, and all of these are real GMAT questions. So aapki practice, you'll get more familiar with what these questions are like. Is that fine? Start. Seconds while I'll change. Question number 69 now. Seconds left. Question number 70. Question number 71. Giving you just extra seconds. Question 72. Cheating nahi karni. Question 73. Question 74. Iski baaki options niche hai, isliye miss, let's skip it. Let's go to 75. One minute left. Time's up. Haji, how do you feel? funny adjectives. Someone saying in pain, someone saying relieved, someone saying tired. Accomplished, that's a good one. But how do you feel after doing this? Like, ye asal questions aise hi hote hain. To ab aap mein se kai logon ne, you hadn't done these kind of questions before. Do you feel more comfortable with the kind of questions that GMAT has, or do you feel more acquainted with the pattern, or do you have more clarity about the questions? Great, that was the objective of it. Let's look at the answers. How many of you, by the way, think you got the answers right? At least half of them. Good self-confidence. Now let's see if you're right about that. 68. What did most people pick? E. Yes. E is the correct answer. Woo, you're learning. Great. 69. Dog? It is D. Anyone who wants to read out why it's D? Agar koi confusion hai, toh we can. That's not a problem. So 69 is D for dog. 70. Wow, bhai. Yes. 70 is C for Charlie. 71. D for dog. 72. D for dog. I'm hearing a lot of correct answers. That's really nice. 73. B bat. 74 we skipped, right? 75. Elephant. E. Yeah. Kiske aadhe theek hue hain? It's a good number, but we'll aim for higher. But I hope it was useful. I hope that the review and the grammar and the structure was useful. If you still feel confused about any of these rules or any grammar portions, feel free to come to me and I can refer some resources that can help you brush up on those skills. Thank you.